是我们的喜乐，我们的泉源，我们要来一起来赞美我们的神，阿们。
你是我自由飞翔，不再被 Let us pray.
让我们一起来祷告。
Father, we thank you for the gift of another day.
父神，我们感谢你赐给我们另外的一天。
A day that we can continue to live for you and to serve you.
这是一天我们能够继续的为你而活，而侍奉你的一天。
And as we listen to the preaching of your word,
当我们听你的话语的时候，
help us, Lord, to listen with understanding.
帮助我们，使得我们听了以后，我们也明白。
And let our hearts be open to receive your word.
让我们的心向你的话语敞开。
Allowing your word and your Holy Spirit to change our hearts.
让你的话语和你的圣灵来改变我们的心。
And to make us to the very persons you want us to be.
甚至你让你塑造我们成为你要我们成为的一个人。
To the glory of your name.
一切荣耀都归于你的名。
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray.
奉主耶稣基督伟大的名，我们祷告。
Amen. The title of my sermon today is The Future Redemption and Restoration of God's People.
今天我要跟大家分享的就是上帝子民未来的救赎和修复。
And I want to use the Old Testament reading for today.
我要用今天旧约圣经的经文来和大家分享
，which is from the book of Zephaniah chapter 3 verses 14 to 20，
乃是从西番雅书第三章第十四到二十节。
As the text for my sermon today，
这个就是我要跟大家分享的经文。
The book of Zephaniah has got three chapters only，
西番雅书呢只有三章而已。
Its main theme is the coming of the day of the Lord.
它的主题是神的日子的来临。
And Zephaniah chapter 1 verse 14 says, The great day of the Lord is near, near and coming quickly.
西番雅书第一章第十四节那么说，耶和华的大日近临近，临近的甚快。
It records the prophecies about the impending punishment of God, firstly on the heathen nations, namely the Philistia, Moab, Ammon, Cush, and Assyria, because of their sins and the evil things they did against God's people.
这本书的主题是讲到神的日子的来临，耶和华的大日临近。他记载上帝来惩罚的预言，首先临到外邦人，就是腓力地亚、摩亚、亚门、古斯和亚述，就是因他们的罪以及他们对上帝子民所行的恶行。
Secondly, God's punishment on His people, in particular the southern kingdom known as Judah.Because of her sins.
其二，上帝对他的子民因他们的罪所赐下来的惩罚，特别是南国犹大。
Let us look very briefly the sins of Judah.
那么我们在这里稍微看看犹大的罪。
In Zephaniah chapter 1 verse 4 to 5, the people of God, they worship idols instead of worshiping God.
在西番雅书第三章第一章第四到第五节，就是讲到呢，以色列人在那个时候呢，他们敬拜偶像。
It is a sin of idolatry.
那个就是拜偶像的罪。
And then we read in chapter 3 verse 1, there were oppressors, rebellious and defiled people.
在第三章第一节，我们有看见他们的罪呢，包括成为压迫者、叛逆和玷污。
They obeyed no one, accept no correction, did not trust in the Lord, and did not draw near to her God.
在第二节里面讲到，他们谁都不顺服，不接受改正，不信靠神和不亲近神。
Then in chapter 3, verse 3, their officials are roaring lions, rulers are evening wolves who leave nothing for the morning.
在第三章第三节，我们也念到，他中间的首领是暴笑的狮子， 他的审判官是晚上的豺狼，一点失误也不留到早晨。
And the prophets are arrogant and treacherous men.
甚至于呢，在第四节里面讲到，他的先知是虚浮诡诈的人。
And their priests profane the sanctuary and do not do violence to the law.
他们的祭司呢，是亵渎圣所、强解律法的。
They were shameless people. They know no shame.
他们是不知羞耻的。
And then in chapter 3 verse 7, they were unrepentant people.
在第三章第七节也讲到，他们是不懊悔的人。
They were eager to act corruptly in all they did.
所以形容他们就在一切事上败坏自己。
Because of her unrepentant heart, the Lord pronounced His impending punishment on His people, Judah in particular.
因他不懊悔的心，神宣告对他来临的惩罚就是犹大。
So we read in chapter 3 verse 8, Therefore, wait for me, declares the Lord. For the day I will stand up to testify, I have decided to assemble the nations, to gather the kingdoms, and to pour out my wrath on them, all my fierce anger. The whole world will be consumed by fire of my jealous anger.
在第三章第八节，那么说，耶和华说，你们要等候我，直到我兴起掳驾的日子，因为我已定义召聚列国，召聚列邦，等将我的恼怒，就是我的烈怒，都倾到他们身上。
Historically, the prophecy about God's punishment on His people was fulfilled when Jerusalem was destroyed by the Babylonians under King Nebuchadnezzar about 586 before Christ.
根据历史呢，上帝对他子民惩罚的预言大约在公元前586实现，就是当耶路撒冷被巴比伦王尼布加尼撒毁灭的时候。
The great temple built by King Solomon in Jerusalem was totally destroyed.
那伟大的圣殿就是那所罗门王所建立的圣所呢，在耶路撒冷建造的这个圣所呢，完全被毁灭。
And a great number of those who survived the attack, the remnants, especially the young people, were taken as captive to Babylon.
大多数剩余的幸存者，尤其是年轻人，都成为巴比伦的俘虏。
It must have been a very sad, painful, and unforgettable experience by God's people.
对上帝的子民来说，这肯定是一个非常悲伤、痛苦和难忘的经历。
But the good news is that the book of Zephaniah does not end with the prophecy of God's punishment on His people.
那么我们看见在这里呢，好大好的消息呢，就是西番雅书不是以上帝惩罚他子民的预言而结束，乃是以他子民未来的救赎和修复为结局。
It ends with the future redemption and restoration of his people.
我们看见这本书的终点就是救赎和修复。
So I want to readFrom verse 14 to 20 of Zephaniah chapter 3.
我在这里要督促第十四节到第十八节。
Verse 14, Sing, O daughter of Zion, shout aloud, O Israel, be glad and rejoice with all your heart, O daughter of Jerusalem.
我们在这里一起来看西番雅书第三章第十四到第二十节。第十四节那么说，西安的民啊，应当歌唱；以色列啊，应当欢呼；耶路撒冷的民啊，应当满心欣喜快乐。
The Lord has taken away your punishment; He has turned back your enemy. The Lord, the King of Israel, is with you. Never again will you fear any harm.
在第十五节，那么说，耶和华已经除去你的刑罚。赶出你们的仇敌，以色列的王耶和华在你中间，你必不再惧怕灾祸。
On that day they will say to Jerusalem, Do not fear, O Zion. Do not let your hands hang limp.
当那日必有话向耶路撒冷说，不要惧怕，锡安啊，不要手软。
The Lord your God is with you. He is mighty to save. He will take great delight in you. He will quiet you with his love. He will rejoice over you with singing.
第十七节，耶和华你的神是施行拯救、大有能力的主，他在你中间必因你欣喜快喜乐，默然爱你，因为你喜乐而欢呼。
The sorrows for the appointed feasts I will remove from you. They are a burden and a reproach to you.
那些属你为无大会忧愁，因你担当羞辱的，我必遭拒他们。
At that time I will deal with all who oppressed you. I will rescue the lamb and gather those who have been scattered. I will give them praise and honor in every land where they were put to shame.
在第十九节那么说，我必发办一切苦待你的人，又拯救你瘸腿的，聚集你被赶出的，就是在全地被羞辱的，我必使他们得称赞，有名声。
At that time I will gather you. At the time I will bring you home. I will give you honor and praise among the peoples of the earth. When I restore your fortune before your very eyes, says the Lord.
那时我必领你们进来，聚集你们。我使你们被掳之人归回的时候，就必使你们在地上的万民中有名声，得称赞。这是耶和华说的。
The prophecy about the redemption and restoration of God's people was fulfilled historically.
在历史上呢，这上帝子民救赎和修复的预言已经被应验了。
After 70 years of captivity in Babylon, God's people were allowed to return to Jerusalem in three stages after the fall of Babylon to the Persian king.Cyrus.
过了在巴比伦被掳了七十年后，当巴比伦败在波斯古利王手下后，上帝的子民在三个阶段中被允许回到耶路撒冷。
The first return was around 539 before Christ.
第一个回归呢，就是在公元前539年。
And the second return under Ezra was around 458.Before Christ.
第二个回归在以斯拉的时候呢，是在公元前458年。
And the third return under Nehemiah was around 445 before Christ.
第三次的回归就是在尼西米的时候，是在公元前445年。
I believe there is an eschatological aspect of this prophecy which will be ultimately fulfilled when Jesus returns again.
我相信这预言呢有末世论的层面，当耶稣再来的时候最终应运。
He will save and restore his faithful ones back to their eternal home in heaven.
他将会拯救和修复忠心以他的人，回到他们在天堂永恒的家。
So in Philippians chapter 3 verse 20 to 21 we read.
所以在腓立比书第三章第二十到二十一节我们读到。
But our citizenship is in heaven, and we are eagerly await a savior from there, the Lord Jesus Christ.
我们自是天上的国民，并且等候救主，就是主耶稣基督从天上降临。
Who by the power that enables him to bring everything under his control will transform our lowly bodies so that they will be like his glorious body.
他要按着那能叫万有复归复自己的大能，将我们这卑贱的身体改形变壮，和他自己的荣耀的身体相似。
As I reflect on the words of God through the prophet Zephaniah,
那么我当我思考到西方亚书里上帝的话语的时候，
I can't help but asking myself this question.
我发觉到我问自己这个问题，
What is God saying to us and the people of the world at large in these trying times when we are confronted by the unprecedented pandemic COVID-19?
就是在这个考验的时候，当我们面对这前所未有的新冠肺炎病毒的流行病时，上帝对我们和世人要说什么呢？
Two thoughts come to mind.
在这里呢，两个念头在我脑海出现。
First, it is a wake-up call to the arrogance, unrighteous, unjust, evil doers and sinners to repent.
就是对那些傲慢、邪恶、不公平、行恶的人和罪人所发出的警告，叫他们悔改。
I believe there will be a great harvest of souls at the end of the day.
我深深的相信，在末日的时候，将会有极大丧失灵魂的丰收。
Zephaniah chapter 3 verse 9 says, Then will I purify the lips of the peoples, that all of them may call on the name of the Lord and serve him shoulder to shoulder.
西番雅书第三章第九节那么说，那时我必使万民用清洁的言语好叫好求告我耶和华的名，同心合意的侍奉我。
Secondly,
第二，
It is testing our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ.
现在是我们在主耶稣基督里信心受到考验的时候。
We need to remain faithful to him.
我们需要呢保持对他的忠心。
To his teaching.
我们要坚守他的教导
，and to his mission，
我们要忠心以他的使命
，as we eagerly await to his coming again to save and bring us back to our eternal home in heaven, the new Jerusalem，
并且渴望他等待他的再来，拯救我们，把我们带回我们在天堂永恒的家，就是那新耶路撒冷。
I pray that our God Almighty.Will bless each and every one of you.
我希望我们伟大的神会祝福你们每一位。
Amen.
Amen.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father.The Son and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen.